Simon & Schuster Audio presents Becoming a Restaurateur, Masters at Work, by Patric Kuh. Read by Joy Osmanski.
1. Visionary. Even though it's a midweek night, there's a buzzy feel to the dining room at Here's Looking at You, one of the best restaurants in Los Angeles. If you stepped inside, you'd hear conversations pierced by laughter at the 12 tables and packed bar. You'd see one group of six excitedly pass around handmade bowls of Carolina gold rice topped with a crisp wafer of parsley-flecked crackling chicken skin. When they taste it, they nod in agreement. It's that good. When Lien Ta, the restaurateur who launched the restaurant in 2016, moves about the dining room, she notices other things. She wishes one table had moved on to dessert, but their dinner has yet to be cleared. But hey, over there, a couple is drinking two of the newly launched cocktails, so those seem to be working. Grabbing a napkin from the bar, she bends to pick up two shishito pepper stems on the floor. Seeing a man in a loosened tie, a semi-regular who's joined a larger group, she waves, then greets him with a warm smile. And by name. A good restaurant should feel as welcoming as someone's home. After all, restaurateurs see you as guests, not customers. Except a home isn't a business, with all the practical requirements of overhead and wages and reports. But Lien, like many other restaurateurs, knows that when the math of an evening has been calculated, what guests will remember most is how a place made them feel. Which is why her main focus is setting the right tone from the start. When the phone rings, she answers with enthusiasm. When a guest emails with a special event request to buy out the entire restaurant, she replies in such a way that propels them forward with their plans. And she has clear ideas of how she wants the guests greeted. Having checked the dining room, she moves quickly to join the new hostess at the narrow wood stand immediately inside the door. Lien, for example, doesn't want her hostesses greeting single diners at her restaurant with the phrase, "Just one?" She feels it sounds judgy. On a busy night, she'd rather book a 6 p.m. than a 6:30 p.m. reservation, because she'll get the table back for a second turn at 8 p.m. She sets the time for slots herself, 1 hour and 45 minutes for 2 hours for 4. The online reservation system will never allow parties to overlap. It will always play it safe. Lien takes pains to make sure each guest feels welcomed at the start of the meal and relaxed through its conclusion. But a restaurateur's mission is to fill seats. This is L.A., people will no-show. Because the Wiltern Theater, a landmark seafoam green Art Deco tower, is nearby, some folks will actually arrive to their 6 p.m. reservation on time and eat quickly to make the show. So the table is free when the next group arrives at 8 p.m. But when that doesn't happen, the time for the next party's wait, referred to as the quote time, has to be delivered in an upbeat, positive way that makes people resolve a few minutes' wait is not a big deal. When things really start to drag, there's always the option of offering a drink on the house. Over and over again, Lien must balance guests' experiences with her financial reality. That kind of constant balancing is what it takes to succeed in this demanding career. Here's the reality. It's high risk. It's long hours. It can be bureaucratic hell. But at the end of the day, it is also deeply satisfying. No matter whether you get into the industry through a part-time summer job or with a degree in hospitality from a prestigious university, make sure that the business is right for you and that you're right for it. Each staff member, for example, has a different and highly specific set of responsibilities, so it's no surprise that when Lien trains a new hostess, she stands right beside her. The young woman at the stand tonight is on her third shift and has been doing well. She did not say just one to the solitary diner who happened in after exploring the neighborhood. Seeing another party was lingering, the hostess extended their stay, which meant that they were still seated when the next party tumbled out of an Uber in high spirits. Lynn flashed a welcoming smile, but stepped back to watch the tone, engagement, and sense of welcome the hostess extended. And she allowed herself a smile when the young woman quickly changed the seating chart, getting that party another table, a better table, in fact, that had opened up moments earlier. Located one block north of Wilshire Boulevard, Here's Looking at You, or HLAY, as those who work there pronounce it, occupies the ground floor of a building on a corner of 6th Street just northeast of Wilshire and Western, two of LA's busier thoroughfares and an intersection that serves as the heart of what has become America's largest Koreatown. The restaurant sits among the neighborhood soju joints, bulgogi halls, Paris-themed patisseries, and all-night steam saunas. It shares the ground floor with a barber, a sushi spot, and a modest general store. Above them is a second floor of offices. Early mixed use? Hard to tell. Though far more modest than the nearby Wiltern Theater, the structure shares a look with the classic building. The zigzag corners and moldings allude to more than embody the Art Deco style that was popular in LA in the 1930s. Over the years, this same spot housed a locksmith with a key-cutting booth, a beauty parlor, and a psychic reader who left behind what is now HLAY's blue neon sign. The restaurant name, inspired by the toast and a card in Lynn's stationery collection, is painted nearby on the glass window in flowing gold script. Lynn and her business partner, Chef Jonathan Whitener, opened HLAY in July of 2016. It has since gone on to represent one of the high points of the city's unaffected and wide-ranging dining style. Having been, respectively, the manager and chef of Animal, the Fairfax Avenue storefront that was a breakthrough success with its gleefully over-the-top flavors, Lynn and Jonathan had instant name recognition in LA's food scene. But it also could have gone the wrong way. New restaurants tend to follow one of two possible patterns. They come out of the gate with every detail thought out, every interaction discussed in pre-shift and executed in service, the message totally focused. Or, in hindsight, their early version was no more than a draft of what the restaurant will become. They need what the neighborhood and its customers bring to define themselves. 3 years after its opening, HLAY is the second kind of restaurant, and it is stronger for it. The assembled mid-century Scandinavian-style furniture, the Morrissey portrait, the minimal look that early on felt almost reserved, turns out to have been just right for a venture in an evolving neighborhood where bone broth halls and skater gear stores were starting to coexist. Wearing their own clothes, a mix of floral patterns, jeans, and heavy cotton aprons, the staff looks approachable, warm, and, well, neighborly. Even having Jonathan's collection of cookbooks ranged in modular bookshelves above the bar and by the entrance kind of makes sense. You never know when you might want to take one down if the conversation turns to Paul Bocuse, the guardian of haute cuisine, or Michel Bras, the descendant who gave it a foraged overlay. Mexican-American on his mother's side, German-American on his father's, and a child of suburban Orange County, Jonathan is able to draw from a slew of cultures and frames them in hard-won technique. There are always signals in Jonathan's cooking, Lynn says, which means the spicy seasoning on the frog's legs may be a nod to the salt and pepper pork chops of a Chinese takeout menu, the dab of cool mayo on the tapioca fritters a wink to a Brazilian pairing he read about. Rigorous yet inviting, the restaurant soon started gathering accolades from online authorities and the national press. Los Angeles Magazine named it one of its top 10 new openings. Jonathan Gold, the longtime Los Angeles Times critic, praised the cognac swizzles served at the bar and the way the radish butter melted over the 30-day dry-aged Holstein ribeye. More recently, a New York Times article on LA's evolving restaurant scene featured a large exterior photo of Hlay. A reminder of the things that have always made this city so dynamic. Noted.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.